Merry Christmas, Seattle! Yes, this is Dr. Fraser Crane coming to you on Christmas Day. Christmas, that very magical time of the year when each moment is as unique as a snowflake, never to be recreated.
I'm sorry, Fraser, the news went over. You're gonna have to do that again.
Merry Christmas, Seattle!
Well, as we head into our second hour, I'd like to lighten things up a bit. Although, Ned, we were certainly glad to hear from you and how you got mugged on your way home from the soup kitchen. Roz, who's next?
We have Don on line 5. He wants to tell us about a time when he was filled with the Christmas spirit.
It's about time. Hello, Don.
Hello, Dr. Crane. Something happened to me yesterday that kind of sums up why we call this a season of giving.
Well, then swaddle me in Christmas cheer.
Okay, well, you see, I was driving home from the gym, and I suddenly realized that I'd left my favorite old pair of sneakers on the roof of the car. So I look back, and there's this homeless guy, and he'd already picked them up, and he's putting them on. So I just thought, what the hell? And I kept driving.
So your experience of the Christmas spirit would be that you didn't slam the car into reverse, speed back there, and rip a pair of smelly old sneakers out of a homeless man's hands. Well, Ross, this is special. I think we got Santa Claus himself on the line.
I'm sorry. That was the last time. I'm okay now. I'm really okay.
No, I'm not.
Barry, listen, I've got to put you on hold for a bit while you pull yourself together, but please, please stay on the line. I'd really like to help you.
It's all right. I think I've got a hold of myself.
So you see, Dr. Crane, I've fallen in the shower so many times. They can't fit any more pins in my hip.
Gladys, listen, can I put you on hold for a second? There's somebody else I have to check on. How's it going there, Barry? My sentiments exactly.
It still traumatizes me, Dr. Crane. I wake up nights and I remember that Christmas morning. I walked into my mother's bedroom, tears running down my face, and I said, Mommy, Mommy, the puppy Santa gave me won't wake up.
Okay, Tom, you win the prize for the saddest Christmas story we've heard today. Happy holidays.
Hi, we're back. Well, you know what? I realize it's been a pretty tough day out there for most of you, and I'd like to hear now from someone who's having a good Christmas. You know, someone who's maybe learned a way to beat the holiday blues. How about it? Well, let's take our first call here. Hello, you're on the air.
Hello, Dr. Crane. This is Jeff.
Hello, Jeff. Merry Christmas.
Well, Merry Christmas to you. I used to get depressed on Christmas, and then I found a surefire way to beat it. I popped my favorite movie, The Sound of Music, in the VCR. Watching Julie Andrews lead those adorable little tykes through the streets of Salzburg, nobody could be depressed. I mean, nobody.
Jeff, are you a betting man? Well, we're just about out of time. My, this day has flown by. I'd like to wish all of you happy revelers out there a Merry Christmas. And for the rest of you, why don't you go out and treat yourself to something special? Personally, I'm going to go get myself a meal at one of Seattle's fine eateries. I don't know where, but I promise you one thing. It'll have a liquor license. Just kidding. Don't drink and drive. This is Dr. Fraser Crane, KACL 780, Talk Radio.